Namaste and once again welcome back to a new mathematics session. Today we shall discuss the methods of solving first order first degree differential equations. The first type is differential equations with variables separable, or we can say variable separable form. A first order first degree differential equation is of the form dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y. Okay, if f of x comma y can be written as the product of g of x into h of y, where g of x is a function of x and h of y is a function of y, then we can reduce this equation as dy by dx is equal to g of x into h of y. Now we can collect the y terms to left side and x term to right side. That means we can take h of y to left side. That is 1 by h of y dy is equal to g of x into dx. To find the solution in this case, we are going to integrate on both sides. Integrating both sides, we get capital H of y. H of y which is equal to g of x plus integrating constant c, where h of y is the integral of 1 by h of y and capital g of x is the integral of this function g of x and c is the arbitrary constant. So the steps in variable separable form is, first of all, we have to separate the variables. We have to collect the terms involving y to the left side and we have to take the terms involving x to right side. And then we can integrate and finally we will get the solution of the given differential equations. Okay, now we shall discuss the problems from exercise 9.4. Here the question is, for each of the following differential equations, find the general solution. First one is dy by dx is equal to 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x. First we can separate the variables. Here the terms involving y is dy only, that we can write it on the LHS part. Dy equal to then 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x dx. Okay. Now we can integrate. Integral dy is equal to integral 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x dx. We know integral dy is y. Here we can apply the trigonometric formula. 1 minus cos x 2 sin square x by 2 and 1 plus cos x 2 cos square x by 2 dx. 2 and 2 get cancelled. Y is equal to integral tan square x by 2 dx. That is y is equal to integral sec square x by 2 minus 1 dx. Tan square x is equal to sec square x minus 1. So tan square x by 2. Sec square x by 2 minus 1. Now we can apply the formula. Integral sec square x tan x. Here tan x by 2 divided by derivative of x by 2. 1 by 2. Then minus integral 1 into dx, x plus integrating constant c. Or we can write y is equal to 2 tan x by 2 minus x plus c. This is the general solution. Okay. Next one, dy by dx is equal to root of 4 minus y square, where minus 2 less than y less than 2. Okay. So here we can write 1 by root of 4 minus y square dy is equal to dx. Now the variables are separated. We can integrate. Integral 1 by root of 4 can be written as 2 square. 2 square minus y square dy is equal to integral dx. Integral 1 by root of a square minus x square. That is sin inverse x by a. Here it is sin inverse of y by 2. Which is equal to integral dx is x and plus integrating constant c. Or we can write y by 2 is equal to sin of x plus c. Right. And y is equal to 2 sin x plus c. So the general solution is y is equal to 2 sin x plus c. Clear? Here the next question is dy by dx plus y is equal to 1, where y is not equal to 1. First we can write dy by dx is equal to 1 minus y. Now we can separate the x and y terms. 1 by 1 minus y dy is equal to dx. Integrating both sides, 1 by 1 minus y dy, here integral dx. Here we can write integral minus 1 by 1 minus y, then put a minus outside. Minus of minus plus. Here the derivative of denominator is minus 1. That's why we multiply and divide by 1 minus 1. Okay. Dy which is equal to integral dx. Now we can write minus log mod 1 minus y is equal to x plus c. Here we can write log 1 by 1 minus y. If we take minus to the power, it becomes 1 minus y the whole raised to minus 1. That can be written as 1 by 1 minus y. Okay. And which is equal to x plus c. Now in order to change the logarithm, we can take exponent on both sides. Exponential function and logarithmic function, both are reverse functions. So while taking exponent on both sides, this log will cancel. We get 1 by 1 minus y is equal to e raised to x plus c. And this can be rewritten as e raised to x into e raised to c. Or we can write 1 by e raised to x into e raised to c is equal to 1 minus y. While taking reciprocal, or we can say we cross multiply this term. 1 minus y to right side and e raised to x into e raised to c to left side. That is e raised to minus x into e raised to minus c equal to 1 minus y. We can take minus y to left side. So y is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus c into e raised to minus x. And we can write y is equal to 1 plus a e raised to minus x, where the constant a is equal to minus e raised to minus c. Okay. Now we move on to question number 4. 6 square x into tan y dx plus 6 square y into tan x dy equal to 0. So first we can write 6 square y tan x dy is equal to minus 6 square x into tan y dx. Now we can separate the variables. 6 square y then by tan y dy is equal to here minus 6 square x divided by this tan x dx. Now we can integrate on both sides. Integral 6 square y divided by tan y dy is equal to minus integral 6 square x divided by tan x dx. Here the derivative of tan y is 6 square y. So what we can write is log mod denominator, log mod tan y, here minus log mod tan x, then here we can take the arbitrary constant as log c. Okay. Now we can take this minus term to left side, that is log mod tan y plus log mod tan x is equal to log c. Here we can apply the property of logarithm, log a plus log b, that is log a b. Here log tan x tan y is equal to log c. Now we can take exponent on both sides, logarithm get cancelled, we get tan x into tan y is equal to c. So general solution is tan x into tan y is equal to c. Okay. Next one, e raised to x plus e raised to minus x into dy minus of e raised to x minus e raised to minus x into dx equal to 0.
First we can write e raised to x plus e raised to minus x into dy, which is equal to, we can take this term to right side, e raised to x minus e raised to minus x into dx. Now we can write dy is equal to e raised to x minus e raised to minus x divided by this one, e raised to x plus e raised to minus x dx. Now the variables are separated, we can integrate. Integral dy is equal to integral e raised to x minus e raised to minus x by e raised to x plus e raised to minus x dx. When we look at the fraction, here the derivative of denominator is on the numerator. E raised to x derivative, e raised to x, e raised to minus x derivative, minus e raised to minus x. So what we can write is log mod denominator. Left side integral dy, integral dy is y. So we can write y is equal to log mod e raised to x plus e raised to minus x plus c. Okay. Next one, dy by dx equal to 1 plus x square into 1 plus y square. So we can write 1 by 1 plus y square dy equal to 1 plus x square dx. Now we can integrate on both sides. Integral 1 by 1 plus y square dy is equal to integral 1 plus x square dx. Integral 1 by 1 plus y square, that is tan inverse y. So tan inverse y is equal to integral 1 dx, that is x, then plus integral x square dx, x cube divided by 3, then plus integrating constant c. So tan inverse y is equal to x plus x cube by 3 plus c. Okay. Next one, y log y dx minus x dy equal to 0. So this can be rewritten as x dy is equal to y log y dx. If we take this negative term to right side, we can write x dy is equal to y into log y dx. Now we can separate the variables. 1 by y log y dy is equal to 1 by x dx. We can integrate. Integral 1 by y log y dy is equal to integral 1 by x dx. In the LHS part, we can rewrite the term, that is integral 1 by log y dy, which is equal to integral 1 by x dx. Now the derivative of denominator is on the numerator, log y derivative 1 by y. Okay, so what we can write is log mod denominator. So log mod log y, which is equal to here log mod x. Then we can write the integrating constant, here it is log c. Okay, it's an arbitrary constant, so we can write any constant. Here I write log c. Log mod log y, which is equal to log a plus log b. Log a plus log b is log a b. So here we can write log xc or cx. Okay. Now we can take exponent on both sides. Logarithm get cancelled. We get log y is equal to cx. Once again we can take exponent on both sides. We get y is equal to e raised to cx. So our final answer is y is equal to e raised to cx. Okay. Here the next question is, x raised to 5 into dy by dx equal to minus y raised to 5. So here we can separate the variables. 1 by y raised to 5 dy equal to minus 1 by x raised to 5 dx. Okay, here we take this y raised to 5 to left side, dx to right side, and x raised to 5 also to right side. Again we can write y raised to minus 5 dy equal to minus x raised to minus 5 dx. Now we can integrate on both sides. Integral y raised to minus 5 dy equal to minus of integral x raised to minus 5 dx. That is y raised to minus 5 plus 1, that is minus 4 divided by minus 4, which is equal to minus of x raised to minus 4 divided by minus 4 plus c.
Okay.
Here we can cancel this minus and minus. Now we can multiply the entire equation by 1 minus 4. Multiplying throughout by minus 4. So what we get is here minus 4 get cancelled. We get y raised to minus 4 is equal to. Here 4 get cancelled. We get minus x raised to minus 4. Then plus c into minus 4. C into minus 4 is minus 4c. Take this term to left side. X raised to minus 4 plus y raised to minus 4 equal to minus 4c, or we can write x raised to minus 4 plus y raised to minus 4 equal to some constant k, where k is equal to minus 4c.
Okay.
Now we move on to question number 9. Dy by dx is equal to sin inverse x. So after separating the variables, we get dy is equal to sin inverse x into dx. Now we can integrate. Integral dy is equal to integral sin inverse x dx. Integral dy is y. Here we can write sin inverse x into 1 dx, and we can apply integration by parts rule. So y is equal to first function sin inverse x into integral of second. Integral 1 dx is x. Minus integral of derivative of first one. Sin inverse x derivative 1 by root of 1 minus x square. Then integral of second function, that is x dx. So y is equal to x into sin inverse x. Here we can write plus, then we can multiply and divide on 2. 1 by 2 integral minus 2 divided by root 1 minus x square dx. Here we have an x. So minus 2x divided by root 1 minus x square. Now the derivative of the term inside this radical sign is on the numerator. That means integral f dash of x divided by root f of x dx. And the answer is 2 root f of x. Okay. So what we can write is y is equal to x into sin inverse x, then plus 1 by 2 into 2 root 1 minus x square plus c. This 2 and 2 get cancelled. Therefore y is equal to x into sin inverse x plus root of 1 minus x square plus integrating constant c. Clear? Next one, e raised to x into tan y dx plus 1 minus e raised to x into sec square y dy equal to 0. So first we can write 1 minus e raised to x into sec square y dy, which is equal to minus e raised to x into tan y dx. Now we can separate the variables. Sec square y divided by tan y dy, which is equal to minus e raised to x by this one, 1 minus e raised to x dx. Now we can integrate. Integral sec square y divided by tan y dy, which is equal to integral minus e raised to x divided by 1 minus e raised to x dx. Here the derivative of tan y is sec square y, so log mod tan y, which is equal to, here also the derivative of denominator is on the numerator, so log mod denominator, log mod 1 minus e raised to x, then we can write the integrating constant as log c. Okay. So left side log mod tan y, which is equal to, here it is log a plus log b, so log a b, log c into 1 minus e raised to x. Now we can take exponents on both sides. Logarithm get cancelled. We get tan y is equal to c into 1 minus e raised to x. So the general solution is tan y is equal to c into 1 minus e raised to x. So that's all for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. The remaining questions we will discuss in the next class.
Thanks for watching. Thank you.